Today is the Wednesday of Holy Week. These are our lectionary readings out of our scriptures for today. First from Isaiah chapter 50. The Lord God has given me the tongue of a teacher, that I may know how to sustain the weary with a word. Morning by morning, he wakens my ear to listen as those who are taught. The Lord God has opened my ear, and I was not rebellious. I didn't turn backwards. I gave my back to those who struck me, my cheek to those who pulled my beard. I did not hide my face from insult and spitting. The Lord God helped me. Therefore, I have not been disgraced. Therefore, I have set my face like flint, and I know that I shall not be put to shame. He who vindicates me is near. Who will contend with me? Let us stand up together. Who are my adversaries? Let them confront me. It is the Lord God who helps me. Who will declare me guilty? And from Psalm 70. Be pleased, O God, to deliver me. O Lord, make haste to help me. Let those be put to shame and confusion who seek my life. Let those be turned back, brought to dishonor, who desire to hurt me. Let those who say, aha, turn back because of their shame. Let all those who seek you rejoice and be glad in you. Let those who love your salvation say evermore, God is great. But I am poor and needy. Hasten to me, O God, for you are my help and my deliverer, O Lord. Do not delay. From the letter to the Hebrews, chapter 12. Therefore, since we are surrounded by such a great cloud of witnesses, let us also lay aside every weight and the sin that clings so closely. Let us run with perseverance the race that is set out before us. Looking to Jesus, the pioneer and perfecter of our faith, who, for the sake of the joy that was set before him, endured the cross, disregarding its shame, and has taken his seat at the right hand of the throne of God. Consider him who endured such hostility against himself from sinners, so that you may not grow weary or lose heart. Thank you. and then the Gospel of John, chapter 13. After saying this, Jesus was troubled in spirit and declared, "Very truly I tell you, one of you will betray me." The disciples looked at one another, uncertain of whom he was speaking. One of his disciples, the one whom Jesus loved, was reclining next to him. So Simon Peter motioned to him to ask Jesus of whom it was he was speaking. So while reclining next to Jesus, the disciple asked him, "Lord, who is it?" Jesus answered, "It's the one to whom I give this piece of bread that I have dipped in the dish." So when he dipped the piece of bread, he gave it to Judas, son of Simon Iscariot. After he received the piece of bread, Satan entered into him. And Jesus said, "Do quickly what you're going to do." Now, no one at the table knew why he said this to them. Some thought that because Judas had the common purse, Jesus was telling him, "Buy what you need for the festival," or he should give something to the poor. But after receiving the piece of bread, Judas immediately went out, and it was night. When he had gone out, Jesus said, "Now the Son of Man has been glorified, and God has been glorified in him. If God has been glorified in him, God will also glorify him in himself and will glorify him at once."
Thank you.